Obesity is really a serious issue, and it's getting more serious over the years, particularly among children and young people. Chinese people are actually more vulnerable genetically to obesity-induced problems, such as diabetes. So in the early 1980s, the diabetes rate was really low, less than 0.5%. But now it's almost over 10%. So in New England Journal of Medicine, there's a paper about this problem. So they report that we have about 100 million diabetic people in China and 150 million pre-diabetic. So that means given 5 to 10 years, you will have those 150 million people would become diabetic mostly. So it's a serious problem. And the reason is the rapidly developing economy of China and the change of lifestyle and diet associated with this rapid development. Well, those are what we call non-communicable diseases or chronic diseases, mainly related with obesity, such as cardiovascular diseases and diabetes, and some form of cancer, like colon cancer, breast cancer. These are increasing very rapidly and to a very high level now. And the cost to the society, to the family, and to the government is really huge. World Bank, they recently issued a report on this chronic disease problem in China. And they predict that from 2010 to 2040, so in those 30 years, if you can reduce the mortality due to cardiovascular disease by 1%, you would save, the money you saved would be equivalent to 70% of the GDP of 2010 of whole China. So that is about 1,000 billion American dollars. Just one disease, if you can reduce 1% of the death rate, would save you that much of money. So if you add all the other diseases and all together, so the money you can save, or actually if you don't do anything, the money it will cost you would be astronomical. And so it will be a really threat to the whole China, to the national security, to the economy, and to the society. Yes, so when we started to open to the Western world, and we start to learn many things from the West, including nutritional science, food science, and technology, and of course, you also have the lifestyle. Many things are coming to China, and so unfortunately, the eating habits and the lifestyle, so mainly unbalanced nutrition and also lack of physical activity, is also coming to China and become adopted by many Chinese people. And so this would also change the disease spectrum of Chinese people. So before we open to the West, the most serious problems are related with infectious diseases. So most people died from infectious diseases. But now the disease spectrum has shifted to non-communicable diseases, chronic diseases. So now it's maybe 80% of people die from chronic problems. So this is really a change of dietary habits and a change of lifestyle. So it's there's a book called China Study by Professor Campbell. And he did a huge epidemiological study over about 60 counties in China over almost 30 years. So his data clearly showed that if you change your diet and lifestyle, and you change the disease that people get. It is possible that some of the healthy traditional Chinese eating habits may be adopted in the future by the Western world. The reason I say that is we have a very long tradition of using diet as medicine to prevent or even to treat diseases. So in China, we have a list of plants published by the Ministry of Health. We call them medicinal food. So those plants can be used as food. At the same time, they can also be used as medicine by Chinese traditional doctors. So those foods actually have some real efficacy in treating or preventing problems. So as one example, there's one particular compound called berberine. It was extracted and identified from a Chinese herb. So this berberine has been recently showed in many papers that they can it can prevent and treat diabetes and reduce weight, reduce cholesterol. And we published a paper to show that this berberine can actually change the composition of gut bacteria living inside our gut. So they can reduce harmful bacteria, toxin producing bacteria, and they can promote beneficial bacteria. So by changing this composition of gut bacteria, and they can reduce inflammation, reduce weight, and help prevent obesity or diabetes, or even to treat diabetes. So if we work more on such plants and understand the mechanism behind why those plants can be used both as food and as medicine, I think eventually this new knowledge can be adopted and the plants will be also used in the West. So actually berberine has become a food additive in many of the Western countries. And so people already start to use some of the key ingredients from traditional Chinese diet or Chinese medicine. So I think this is very possible that some of the Chinese traditional diet can help the Western world. Yeah.